Welcome to Senior Master Technician Productions. This video is the first in a series showing the cab removal and installation of a 2008 through 2010 Ford Super Duty. This video is just a representation of the procedure to show the extent of the process. The first steps would be to place the vehicle in position to lift the cab. Start disassembly by removing both headlamp housings. You will need to drain the cooling system and dispose of properly. I like to start at the front, then from left to right. I start with disconnecting the transmission cooler lines at the auxiliary and radiator cooler line fittings. I also use vacuum caps to prevent dripping and contamination. Next is to disconnect the power steering cooler line from the auxiliary cooler. Now we're ready to disconnect the batteries. I start by disconnecting both negative terminals first, then positive connections. This is also a good time to recover your AC system. You may need to remove the air filter housing to reach the low pressure fitting. Yes, I almost forgot. Time to use some fender cover. Now I can remove the left-hand battery to use as my step stool. If four-wheel drive, disconnect vacuum hoses at reservoir. Start disconnecting degas hose from reservoir. I normally just disconnect the hose from the reservoir and from the vertical EGR cooler and leave the other end connected on the radiator. Now I will disconnect the fuel cooler hoses. You want to prevent the fuel cooling system from losing any coolant and getting air into the system. No fuel lines will need to be disconnected at this time. Remove clip from upper radiator hose and disconnect from radiator. Now we can start the removal of the degas reservoir. Remove the clip from the lower degas hose to remove hose. Here I disconnect the charge air cooler hose at the high pressure turbo outlet. I secure with bungee to upper radiator support. Now I can position the fuel cooler hoses over the top of the radiator support as shown. You can leave the upper radiator hose connected to the thermostat housing and position towards the engine. Disconnect the heater return hose from graphite piping and position out of the way. This hose will rise with the cab during removal. In this poor quality video, disconnect the three main harness connectors on the left-hand spring shock tower. Next, disconnect the three connectors from the master cylinder, brake fluid level sensor, brake deactivation switch, and brake fluid pressure sensor. Position the wiring to raise with the cab. Connection mounted to spring tower will stay with the chassis during removal. Now we are ready to remove the master cylinder. Reposition power steering hose bracket to remove master cylinder. With the master cylinder removed, position over and onto engine and secure with bungee. Again, sorry about the poor video quality. I know it's hard to see. Next, you need to disconnect the steering sector shaft bolt and compress the shaft for cab removal. Last on this left-hand side is to disconnect the power steering lines from the hydro boost and the pump supply line from the reservoir and position towards engine. The disassembly of the left-hand side and front is now complete, and so is this video. Stay tuned for part 2 showing the completion of the removal of the cab and the cab removal itself. Please don't forget to like and comment this video, and you're welcome to visit us anytime on Facebook, Senior Master Technician.